decided to try exploring creation with mathematics. That's great. I'm excited for you. And now you're trying to sort out which level is right for your child. I get this question a lot, so let me give you as much help as I can. Exploring creation with mathematics is leveled in a way that is very simple. So the level corresponds with the grade. So level 5 is a traditional 5th grade year of math, and that's how it works for level 1, level 2, just so you know that. Most kids take 1 year to complete one level. Also, I designed the program to be pretty much on grade level. I didn't want to make it more advanced. It's not remedial. I try to keep it true to that level, and then I thought you as a parent can decide if your child should be moved up or moved down to review, that type of thing. Okay, but that is how it is leveled. How do you pick the right level? Well, the first thing you should do is go to Apologia's website and check out the placement guide that they created. It's the best place to start. We list what's covered in each level, and you as the parent can assess, does your child know that skill? Are they confident in that skill? And it lets you see it all laid out. Sometimes parents even compare that with other programs if they're debating between two different programs, that type of thing. It's just a great bird's eye view. So that's the placement guide. The other thing that I'd recommend you check out is I have made video overviews of all the levels. So some parents find that helpful as well, to watch a flip through and just kind of see it, right? To really see inside the book and get a sense of what the year would look like. In addition to my flip throughs, you can go watch somebody else's flip through. And maybe you'd rather watch somebody else than me, the author. I totally respect that. Okay, now I just want to address, sometimes you feel your kid is between two levels. You're not the only one. I get this message from parents. They are right in the middle, or I'm not sure, how do I handle this? They know some of level 4, but not all of it. What do I do? Well, first of all, little pep talk, you as the homeschool parent always are the best person to make that decision. You know your kid, you know how they're wired, how much drive they're bringing to the table. So, you know, I just want to affirm that you are the best person to make the decision, but here's some things to consider. One, and this is just my opinion, if your child knows more than 50% of what is covered in a level, definitely consider bumping them up. I'm not saying all the time, but I think sometimes as parents, we are very hesitant to push a kid up because we're worried they'll miss something. And what can happen is they can get bored, and it's a very long year, and they actually don't learn as much as they could, not just because they weren't on the higher level, but because there was so much of a lack of challenge that they weren't very motivated. So just be careful about being overly careful. Okay, if you're under 50%, yeah, you really need to weigh things. You're probably gonna bump them down. Some parents have gone to the lower level and they've moved more quickly, skipped chapters of things that they already knew. I know one mom said they didn't do the projects and they kind of jumped around and they got through it maybe in half a year just to make sure there weren't any gaps, right? This is the beauty of homeschooling. You can adapt. If you do jump up, one thing to consider is how you're gonna fill in gaps. And I would definitely recommend that you look at the skills practice for the previous level. So every level has the student book, that's the spiral bound one, and the teaching guide. And in the teaching guide, there's something called the daily skills practice. It's right in the front, and it's certain skills that the kids continue to review throughout the year, okay? So you wanna look at that for the previous level. So if your child really doesn't know how to add and subtract decimals, or you know, you're thinking of them putting them in level 3 and they're not really strong on adding and subtracting with regrouping, that's something you wanna review and shore up before you start. The levels do overlap to some degree, but that's just me trying to position you for success. A lot of you are switching in from other programs. And first of all, I really appreciate that you're checking out Apologia Math and that you're thinking about it. So thank you. Also, you should know that, of course, we designed the program to build level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4, level 5, but we also took into account that there would be families that would jump in midstream. So we thought about you, we planned for you, so I just don't want you to be overly concerned about changing things up. So those are my thoughts. Please feel free to comment, send in questions. I hope that is helpful, and thanks so much for choosing Apologia Math.